before the hunt. Old B-Mac got the tag. Starts tomorrow morning, so we're gonna go and check at least one, maybe two of our trail cameras.
So much anticipation. We haven't been back here since like the middle of July, so super anxious to see how they've grown out and what else is on here.
96% battery and 230 pigs. Check it out. Here we go. Oh yeah, we saw this one. We saw this one on both trips up here. He's got no eye guards, yep. He turned out pretty good. Man, those stealth cams take a pretty good picture. Look at that. It's been a while. Pretty buck. Oh, check it out, dude. That's a quad pod. If you guys followed our scouting season, you remember this buck last year. He was actually a really big non-typical. Yeah, he's really gone downhill. Here, this is how we know it's him. It's hard to tell probably on the screen, but he's got half of an ear on his right ear. So he's really recognizable. Big eye guards, but man, he just did not do anything this year.
It's getting pretty intense up here. Casey's about 100 yards from the bucks. They're about to step out where he can see him, but the bucks are gonna walk right past one of my trail cameras that we checked yesterday. It's looking good. Fingers crossed, guys. Dang it, guys, that was seriously so close. Casey must have been, I don't know, 80 yards from those big bucks. That hillside is so steep. That's actually the hillside that I missed two bucks on last year. And with that brush being, you know, knee to waist high, it could screw up everything. But so far, all we know is that Casey was just a little too low. The bucks came out, and the big buck got nervous. I could tell by his body language, and he was not going down. He wanted to go up. So we took a bunch of phone scope. Really cool video through the phone scope.
You guys see that cow moose right there? You see her rump right there. Cruising down through this aspen draw.
Baby.
You got baby? Oh, yep. This is when being close to moose can actually be dangerous. I don't feel threatened at all right now, but you get in between mom and baby moose, you might be in the danger zone. Midday of day two, Casey got on a pretty cool buck today. Two cool bucks, actually. The two bucks we've been watching. And the hunt's going good, but I wanted to get on here and do like a vlog update for just the Wednesday updates and keep you guys up to date of what's going on. We are in the high country of Utah. Midday right now, pretty slow going for the hunt, so Andy and I are actually headed down to refill the water. You got your backpack full of water bottles. This giant pack is full of water bottles. And the only thing that sucks about our deer camp is running water is about a mile and a half away. So the only way to go get it is to load the pack and you go down there and fill up your water bottle. So that's what we're doing. Finally found the source. It was a little further down the canyon than I thought. I've crossed this creek down below a couple times, but I always figured it had to start somewhere, and we just found where it started. Look at this crystal clear natural spring water. But we got a pretty good system. The backpack full of empty bottles. Andy there is the faucet man. Look at this. Look at that clean natural spring water. Guys, people pay high dollar for this stuff right here. It's free 99. The only 99 is all the plastic bottles. I'm gonna have like 10 pounds of water in my guts after this. When you're at the spring, you drink as much as you can. How's that?
It's so good.
Chuck full, every single one of them. Then we gotta load them up in the backpacks. Andy's got the full curl. I've got my curl and my big bag ready to lock down, load it up. And I know you can't see it from here, but we're going way that way. This is actually fun, guys, I'll admit. When it comes to like hard work and doing this kind of stuff around camp, I enjoy it. I'm always excited to go do little adventures like this. You learn a lot, actually. I think you learn a lot about the deer, the animals. You can see the high amount of traffic around here. There's definitely a lot of wildlife that use this spot for their water hole. Getting all the, what are those called again? Iodine.
Aqua, yeah.
Iodine pills.
Iodine tablets.
One tablet does a liter.
Yeah, which is like 38 ounces we decided.
32
ounces.
So these really only need about a half, but yeah, we've got a lot of pills, so we're playing it safe.
Luckily we have a couple studs up here, Andy and Eric, that would walk down to get the to refill.
We decided on the way down that you guys are the hunters and we're the gatherers.
Yeah, that's true.
So you guys better produce some meat tonight.
You gathered the water. Deal.
We don't have any food.
Deal. I'll throw some backstraps down on this water party we're going to have. That's refreshing.
There's our stash.
To see that, though.
These iodine pills, if you guys have never used them, you can see them inside there. It gives it a really weird coloration. Almost looks dirty. But
you really can't
it has a little bit of flavor, but it's not really that bad. We've used them a lot in our high country Nevada hunt, and I actually got to the point where I liked the iodine flavor. We drank so many of them. Beats Giardia, apparently.
All
right, guys, it is the evening of day number 3. This morning was super slow, like extremely slow. We saw a good buck, but he got bumped by some hunters. And yesterday, these two big bucks, Quad Pod and Tall Boy, got bumped down in this canyon below me. And when that usually happens, I know they end up in one of two places, and tonight I picked him out. Really, really pretty buck, really symmetrical. He's got a nice gray coat on him right now. I'll try to just get some footage for you guys on the phone scope and show you, but tonight could be the night. Buck we're waiting for, he's about to walk out. He needs to come this way towards me. If he does, he'll walk right to Casey. Here he is. Check that out. All right, guys, that's the end of our hunt this week. A little bit of a tour of camp, so you guys can kind of see how we've been living the last 6-7 days.
It's a clothesline. We've got, starting from the left, socks, bikini briefs, shorts, and you can see the rest. This was called originally the hammock hut, where that hammock was over here closer, where I was sleeping next to Eric. And then I realized this body is not created to sleep in a hammock.
You abandoned me, dude.
Well, I had to, okay? I got no sleep the first two nights. The third night, I did get some good sleep. Eric, on the other hand, he's built to sleep in the hammock. He loves it.
I have it made. I got a nice sleeping bag, flannel on the inside, a pillow.
Flannel,
yeah.
Pillow, hammock. I think Eric has a hammock in his bedroom at home. Anyway, so that's the hammock hut.
Here's a bunch of the gear that we used. Extra batteries and SD cards. We got the dark energy camera, spotting scopes, tripods.
Let me just tell you, this came in handy. Energy solar.
It did. Yep, we used energy solar to charge our devices like our cell phones. So radios never used them, trail cam never used it. But we'll move up here. What's this section?
This is the goodie section. It's treasure chest, we like to call it. This is what we found on the mountain, which is pretty saddening because obviously it's come from hunters and they just abandoned their camp. And so it just becomes trash on the hill.
Lots of garbage. It was all, it looked like it was hoisted up into that tree,
yeah,
in that bag.
System. It was up in the tree and then I think the tree fell or something.
It's mostly garbage. There's one sleeping bag in there, but it had been eaten by the rodents.
Anyway, so we come over here. So this was D-Mac's tent. D-Mac could only stay for 2 days or 3 days. And then when he left, I bailed on Eric and slept in here. It was really nice. So I got my gear here, my backpack, Horn Hunter. I'm going to drink this before we leave. Eric packed up protein. Knowing Eric, good on him because that stuff's good. Got some Yeti, got the Hoyt, which was never fired this week, guys. Saddening. Let's come down here, though. We got the cameraman. We kind of stick them off in the corner. We got Andy set up here. We got the tent. All Andy's gear over there. How was the accommodations, Andrew?
It was good.
Sleep good?
Yeah, I used one of the mats we found up on the hill.
Yeah.
Put it under the tent and then had the thermal rest on top of that.
Double pillow top. Dude, he's even got
plus
a little square
pad
pillow.
Under here.
Not bad.
Come over into probably our favorite part of camp, the kitchen. Doesn't look much like a kitchen because we're starting to put all the food away, but we built this for the Camp Chef Striker, where we'd boil water for mountain houses and other sorts of beans and stuff that me and Andy ate all weekend. But got the kitchen,
kitchen, nice. This is a pan. We would build this up so I could burn underneath it.
Yeah, originally this was Eric's cooking station. Then he was like, went all organic, no MGOs, and started cooking on the fire.
I did start cooking on the fire pit,
which was nice cool. Because you don't burn gas. Built this fireplace up, dug it out, which is super nice, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. It was nice. We actually leveled this log while we were up here, because nothing up here is flat. We got tires sitting on an angle, so we leveled this up, and it's, we don't have a level, but if we were to put a level to it, it'd be perfect flat. And then just stuff we really didn't use, but we packed up here, like the big bag for the Horn Hunter, which I carried all my food and water in. I just hung it up. Guys, I used to always make fun of everyone that used to use these trekking poles. Like, those are for old men. Last year in Colorado, I shot a buck way back, not way back, but a couple miles deep, and it was steep. And Brian carried him, and me and Eric were always making fun of him. And then he gave me one to come out. Anyways, after that trip, I was like, I'm getting trekking poles. I am an old man, you know? Yeah, they got some more backpacks. It's camp, this is deer camp, which it, honestly, this is a really cool place. Eric found a couple years ago, and we've been hunting it for 2 years now. And it's rad, it's way rad. We're way back in here. We've been in here for 7 days now, a week. And I think we could stay for another 7 days if, you know, the people at home would allow us, but we better get home.
Casey and Brian are going antelope hunting in Nevada.
Which is gonna be a completely different setup.
Yeah.
I mean, this is nice and all, but rumor has it, we're gonna take a 12-foot jumping jack there, and it's gonna be plush. We even ventured and call it glamping, if you would. Eric's headed on an antelope hunt with the Mountain Ops guys. They're probably staying in like a 5-star resort or something, which is fine. You know, to each their own.
I like to
rough it a little bit.
Yeah,
to each their own.
Whatever. Take this kid to the mountain to find him all the big bucks. Can't stay off his phone. Refuses. Doing some scouting for a Walker's muzzleloader hunt. Today's gonna be a good day. We're gonna go check the trail cameras that we set about a month ago. See what's on them as far as the bucks go. And then Mr. Walker Boss and I are driving down the canyon and out to a rifle range where we're gonna start sighting in the muzzleloader I bought. So I went and bought a brand new muzzleloader. I put my Vortex Diamondback rifle scope on it. Because here in Utah they passed a law where you can have a variable scope with any power. So Walker is gonna get dialed in.
We gotta get that thing dialed in.
And this is gonna be a fun hunt. Starts September 28th, so we got a little bit of time to do some scouting. But we just got here, so we're gonna check the cameras for the first time. Fingers crossed, because we just saw a decent 4-point. A couple 2 points and like a 3x4 weird one. And there's actually one, a 2-point that was already hard horned. So I'm gonna go snag this stealth cam and see what we got. Okay guys, we're gonna check the card. First card. We have high hopes. We're hoping for a shooter. Let's see what we got. There's a cool 3-point. Barely cut the corner of the camera, triggered. It's pretty sweet. Oh, check that out, dude. Deer is airborne. Looks like the doe and two fawns. I like getting daytime pictures. Oh, yeah, dude. Walker, there's your stud 2 points. Two-point party. That's pretty. A lot of green little bucks. Oh, there we go. Check that out. Dude, that's the buck we just saw this morning. We saw this buck one canyon over this morning. So there he was on 6:15 a.m. 10 days ago. So he's still living here. That's cool. Isn't that pretty sweet? I don't think he found the salt either. Yeah, he just walked on by. Bummer. Once they find the salt, like I said, they'll stick to it. It's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. We got the good 4-point that we saw today on the first trail camera. So that's good. Is he a shooter? I don't know. That's Walker's call. He's not as big as the ones Walker's taking with a gun, but he is hunting with a muzzleloader for the first time. So what do you think of that buck? First thought.
Pass.
pass. All right, let's go to the next camera.
I want the 180.
Wants 180s. Check this out. Evidence. Guys, so when we came up here last time, there were some cow tracks right here. Cow elk, that is. And we were hoping that the second camera, which is like 170 yards that way, would get some elk on it. Not that we're hunting them up here. We're just kind of curious. But this is the kind of detail and, you know, things you want to look for. This is where an elk urinated, obviously. Oh, yeah, that is definitely elk. I mean, you pinch a little bit of that on the top. Yeah, strong. Try it, Walker. I'm gonna teach my little brother how to do it.
Smell some pee. Huh?
Smell some pee. Welcome to the hush life.
Kinda just smells like elk.
Yeah, that's, well, yeah, so that's what's funny you say that is, for you guys that hunt, I mean, you guys know this, but for you guys that don't, when you walk through an area that has been recently hit by elk, you hit a wall, and it's like, elk, everyone stopped, like, all the hunters will be like, dude, did you smell that? That's what that's like.
Yeah, it is.
So the smell of elk is their urine, so welcome to smelling elk, Walker.
That was nice, good to know.
Horny toad, guys, this is one of my favorite, get him, dude, get him before he gets in the bush. Up high. Get him! Get him! Lost him. That was the fastest horny toad ever. Especially for how big he was. Where are you? Oh, I see him. He's so camouflaged. He's in the sun right there, barely. You see him? You see? He's in the shadow. Oh, caught him. That's a big one for these woods. Bring him out here.
Oh my gosh.
Safety first, dude. I got
you. Crazy up here.
Guys, horny toads are probably one of my favorite creatures to catch when we're in the mountains. And sometimes you find a lot of them, and sometimes you just don't see them at all, but look how cool they are.
The spikes on them.
They're like prehistoric miniature dinosaurs.
Oh. Yeah, they're like hard.
All right. We're gonna let it go, buddy. Thanks for the entertainment. Keep it real. Look how camouflaged he is. Oh, I love horny toads. All right, see you, buddy. We're just gonna walk past you on the trail, okay? How cool is that? Dude, that thing was way faster than you. Update, camera number two had nothing worth even filming for you guys. So, fast forward to camera number three. I always like to come up to these, hit menu while it's still turned on. Wow, a whopping 24 pictures. This is definitely not a spot. But it's good to know. That's the only way you learn is by spreading out cameras and doing scouting. We're checking off one by one where not to go to narrow down where to go. And so far, that's going to be right by camera number one. I'm still going to leave this camera. I'm guessing with the amount of does in here that come the rut, I might be able to just capture some cool pictures. I can't hunt up here. His hunt is September 28th through October 6th, which is still early season. The bucks are usually still grouped up. This is definitely not going to be the spot, but that was fun. That was a fun day of checking cams. Just going to set it up, leave it, and we're going to go shoot the muzzleloader. BMAC up 100 yards. A little high. A few inches high. Guys, we're at Zeiss Archery Range out here in Bluffdale area, which is kind of like the South Valley of Salt Lake City. And we posted up 100 yards with these guys. They're all out shooting their bows, getting dialed in. Because this weekend is the opener for Utah's archery deer and elk hunts. BMAC and Casey will be the lucky hunters up first. That's right. How'd you feel at 100?